from Cheap Homesteading, and we went to take a look at a modern dairy farm. It's actually my wife's uncle's farm, and they got Lely robots. So this is my father-in-law, and he used to sell Lely robots.
It brings back lots of memories. He used to sell robots.
That is awesome, and we're gonna go take a look. So let's go.
The average 24-hour average is 35.92, so 36.6 liters per cow, and then we're averaging 2.8 milkings per cow per day right now.
2.8.
Yeah. It's 2.8 currently, and the average is 2.9. I guess the 24-hour average.
Wow. That's actually pretty awesome.
That's good.
Yeah. So we have about 20% free time still. That's down here.
What does that mean?
That means like right now we're milking 94 cows. So like we can go to about 7% free time because you need to have some free time for the robots to wash and stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. So we can add. That means we can add another 10 or 15 cows. Probably about 150. We have 117 stalls on that side, but that would include our dry cows as well, Krista. So we have our dry cows in here as well.
Why so they alternate so they don't overheat?
Yes, and if one goes down,
the other one still works.
The other one still works because the robots, there's a lot of components that are operated with air motors. And getting dry air is extremely.
Oh, and that's your dryer.
Yes.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then that's positive air there, that's pumping positive air into the robot room continuously.
Oh, yeah, to keep the dust out, probably.
Yes, keep it pressurized.
Here is the stable cleaner. It's automatic.
Yep.
And you're coming over to see, eh? It knows to move.
It goes slow enough.
So that's the chip on their collar?
Yeah, actually the transponder is on the right side of the cow.
Oh, it is?
And the thing at the bottom is, there.
Yeah.
The thing at the bottom is just a weight to keep that in position.
Okay, so the transponder is the thing on the right hand.
That's
okay,
right.
Yeah. That makes sense. There, so that thing right there.
How long do you have a cow?
We have some cows that are about, I'd say 9 or 10 years old right now.
So this was your family farm growing up, eh?
Yeah, it was.
Do you remember how many cows your dad started off with?
You must know better than I did.
Not very many.
So how many cows did Paca start off with?
Well, in Oldsville, I'm not sure. Dad and Mom, when they came from Holland, they had a dream of having 25, milking 25 cows.
But they milked everything by hand.
Yes, they milked. And then they bought a milking machine, and Beppa, she sent Beppa, like my mom and dad, a letter, and she said, could you and Stuart not milk those few cows by hand, those 25 cows by hand? So we can swing this gate over and tie it up there, and then we can swing that gate over. And then, that was already in there.
So it's already set up to move them wherever you want them to go.
Yeah, we just have to move these gates around. Yeah, she's coming out, that's the actual thing.
Okay, so we're going to go take a look at the robot room.
This cow here, she just came in and now she's getting clean. There's brushes that are cleaning her teeth.
Can I go over here?
She just walks behind you and comes back to that cow.
I'm clear.
back down to 100 degrees.
Okay.
Yeah.
They're still very comfortable.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're working and comfortable. If we'd be standing around, we'd be getting cool.
So the lasers line up the cups and they just go on?
That's correct. The lasers, that's locating the teeth.
Yeah.
And the very first, like if we have a fresh cow, we have to scan it. Like we have to choose on the screen here whether it's a large udder or small udder, so teeth placement. And then we tell it to connect. And the laser searches for the teeth and it memorizes teeth coordinates.
So then each one is known by the chip when it comes in? And
yes.
Correct. So
what are these
units?
This is the behind you. I'll start with what's behind you. This is called the central unit.
Okay.
And this is where the vacuum control is, or the frequency drive.
Okay.
And there's also, these are the chemical pumps. The pumps are for the chemicals that wash the robot as well.
Okay.
Yeah. And then those are, I don't know the scientific term, sorry, Pete.
Oh, no problem, doesn't matter.
But it contains the receiver jar.
Oh, okay, so there's the bottle?
Yeah. Where the milk, and the milk is all weighed when it goes into the jar.
For each cow, and then recorded.
And recorded.
That is something else, eh?
Yeah.
So it's mainly the cows getting used to it, not...
That was a big thing, yeah. It was the owner had to get used to it, but the cows really had to get used to it too.
Yeah.
And the cows, they're grabbing for a cord.
Yeah.
So the cows, each cow when it comes in, she gets weighed.
Oh, so the cows weighed every time too?
Yeah. And that's part of the T4C, it's called Time for Cows, T4C.
Yeah.
And that, it will give you a weight attention. It'll notify you if the cow has a considerable weight loss.
Ah, so you can catch something happening to
it. Right. It also measures the milk temperature every time you milk.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And it tracks, also tracks rumination. So if you have a cow that goes, rumination goes down.
Yeah. So this one here, this is just the cleaning?
Yeah, now it's just going to do a little
cleaning cycle.
Yeah.
It's just going to flush a little bit of water. So it cleans up the cups and then it gets ready for the next one.
That's correct. Yeah.
That's awesome.
There she comes.
The next one. So if it's already just been milked, it'll kick it out.
That's correct.
Transition cows.
Yeah.
For these people. What's transition cows?
Transition cows are cows that are just fresh, or special needs area, you can call it. So these are cows that are being, they just need a little more attention.
Yeah, that's cool. And then your...
These are faraway drying cows.
Yeah.
And 3 weeks prior to calving, they go on to this here maternity
shed. Ah. Nice fencing. You don't even have to move nothing.
No.
It's just swing gates.
That's right.
So when you dump the feed in front of the cows, it just pushes it in farther as they eat it?
Yeah, as they eat it, they push it out. This will push it back in.
And just does it automatically?
Yeah, every hour.
Yeah. Does the charging station just goes there on its own?
Yeah, it knows where to go.
It's kind of like one of those vacuums that go back.
But yeah.
So you run your TMR up here, like your feed mixer, and dump it?
Dry ones here, so it makes you different.
Does it clean the floor too, or?
Yeah, it gets it pretty shiny.
Yeah, so that's actually, I guess it goes by how many times?
Yeah. Wow, it has lost 3 times.
It's funny, it does go up both sides, eh? The middle's not as much.
No, it goes down this way and then it comes back this
way. Ah. Very nice and bright. So how long have you been doing this now, here, with this?
Almost 2 years.
Your dad was saying about the cows taking a little more to get used to it than you guys.
Yeah, it took them a while. I think all of them know how to do it now.
Yeah. Do you actually get more milk because of them?
We haven't yet, but It'll come eventually. They say it takes 5 years to really have to, like, get a transition.
Yeah. So what is that conveyor belt?
That is for the bedding. You drop it down, start the TMR here, and then unload in the belt. And drop it off on conveyor one or conveyor two.
Oh, so it actually swings out onto here, onto the conveyor?
This conveyor drops on the conveyor that goes across.
Uh-huh.
And then I'll drop it on the first conveyor here, or the second one.
Oh, cool.
And then there's a deflector there, goes back and forth, and it drops it in front.
Oh, so the deflector will go to each one.
Yeah.
And then drop it.
Yeah, it just keeps running back and forth, and then when you see there's enough, you shut it off, and then we move it.
Yeah, so you don't even have to get in there to do that.
No, you can just run it from here with control panels over here.
That's a big change from the old burn, eh? The old burn.
Yeah. Yeah, when we first started in this burn, we would bring the TMR right in with the cows.
Oh, yeah?
So we'd have to move the cows onto the other side so we could get it in there. So this way it serves the cows a lot less.
They seem to be happy.
Yeah.
So with the feed mixer, you come in that door, all the way to the end. You go that way, go in that door, and then come out. And the barn is like got some substantial beams.
The curtain's going down because it's getting colder.
Oh, so it automatically closes the curtains.
Yeah.
To keep the temperature inside.
Yeah.
Million. So it'll go up and down if it's hot or cold to keep the right temperature.
Yeah, and the fan will shut off automatically too.
What happens in the winter? Are they closed most of the time? Or
closed all the time, pretty much. There might be one fan running down there.
Yeah. And then it automatically, if it turns hot, it'll
fire up again.
So this is the stable cleaner? What do you call that? Yes. So this is the boot washing station. And so when you wash off the boots, so does that go to the manure pit?
Yeah. It goes to the straight alley back there.
So it's underground?
Yeah.
Like under the concrete?
Yeah.
So those are cameras, so you can see them from home?
Yeah, we can see those from home. And we have some over there, so we can see if cows are having cattle.
Oh yeah, so that's probably really handy.
Yeah, dude. Huh. I'll have to come out to the barn and take some scatters on camera.
Yeah, that is the way you want it. So there is the big milk cooler. And the line's feeding it. The refrigeration unit. Water softener heater. Pressure tank. How many gallons does this thing hold?
It's a 3,000 gallon tank. It holds about 12,000 liters.
12,000 liters. How many gallons did it
hold? 3,000 gallon tank.
Wow, it's the same thing.
And then that's the buffer tank there.
So
that's where it first goes into?
That's where it goes whenever the truck driver comes.
Okay.
So cows keep milking all the time. Right. So you have to have a place for the milk to go into the buffer tank while the tank is washing.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So how long does that process? It must go...
I think probably about an hour that it takes to wash the tank.
And it has enough, you'll never overfill?
No.
That's awesome.
And then there's the twin filters on the wall.
Okay, so you change, so that's the milk that's filtered in there.
That's correct, yeah.
So that's when it comes directly from the robots?
Directly from the robots, yes.
And goes through that.
Yes.
And that's the control unit, isn't it?
Yes.
That's pretty awesome.